Hello everyone, my name is Yelsum, and welcome back to Regrowth. I missed entirely. I don't want these guys. Let's take a peek here, what we do want. Now, fair warning, my voice is definitely doing interesting things right now, and I do blame my wife for this. She decided to bring the plague home from work, so I think I'm developing a cold, I think is the right word for it. But check this out. This is a stable strain of Cobalt B. I got two of them. I took very, very, very slowly. This only has a breeding rate of two or a fertility rate of two. So every time it gave me an extra one, I stuck it over in this one until I had enough to convert a B over. But we have enough now that we are converting these. So what we need to do here is actually take, let's just take a decent chunk of what's left here and split them out into these. 28 will hopefully be enough to get that going, and we'll let that go for a bit. But what this has done for us is we're up to 50 here. We're 59, you can see there's some right there. And if you look at the hot bar, we got cobalt pretty much everything. The reason I went and did that was because you can't move these. Well, apparently you can move ardite, but you cannot move cobalt without cobalt level mining. So I figured we had cobalt, might as well use it for something. And let's take a peek here. This thing, the piece that we were missing last time from the IMEG stuff, or the Academy Craft node here, was this thing. I thought it was a component. It actually wasn't, it was a block. So if we do, every time I spell that wrong. This thing right here, the wireless IMAG matrix, it looks, to me it looks like, you know, the equivalent of like a sci-fi hard drive. It's not. It's actually a 2x2 block that you can open up and you can put three of the constraint metal plates in and the basic matrix. This is what the description in the quest book was trying to tell me that I read a bunch of times and made no, did not make the connection of. This thing you can configure by hitting the little wrenchy thing up here, and you can give it a new password, you can do whatever you want. You can set the SSID, which is what I did. It's on test right now. Then you come over here and you tell this thing you want to search for networks. You click it and you tell it you want to connect, and it's connected. If you need a password, you have to type it in. So this thing is kind of our hub. This is kind of like the main point of our wireless network. Apparently these things have a decent amount of range, because you can see right here, this is the range one. So it looks like it'll do about 50 blocks. That's a weird blinky light thing going on there. So it's got a decent range. If I remember correctly, it's based on the matrix core that I've got in here, and we only had the basic one. And then we got this thing, which is set up. So basically the peripherals connect to the nodes connect into the matrix, the matrices. These things I think can be chained. So I think if we really wanted to within 50 blocks, I want to say we could put another one and move it out even farther. But we'll get there. Now, the thing I really want to work on is the Academy Craft stuff, because I started looking it up online and I think it's Chinese. I think that's what the CN domain names are. I couldn't get the website to work because every time Google tried to translate it, it would close the menus on me. So I couldn't actually get into the menus. So everything I found is based on like year old Reddit posts and stuff like that. But it looks like it's based on an anime series I've watched, which I think it's a certain scientific railgun, which I thought was kind of cool when I read that. It's like, hey, I actually know what they're talking about. But that gets us to down to here. I have been making a lot of stuff. So you can see I got a tank up there because it needed lots of water. So whole bunch of redstone chipsets, whole bunch of tubes. Pretty much, I think I got most of the types of tubes covered. How are we doing over here? You got 64 more of those. You got 64 more of those. So then we come over here. You go in here. You go in here. Lots of these. I set up the bloomery furnace in the basement. I also set up that smeltery there. The black stuff there is something we'll hopefully get to soon. This little guy here has been chugging away producing lots of these. And the whole point of all those was to create a whole ton of these, because I needed a bunch of those to create this stuff, which is the stuff for the various quests. So if we come in here, we got the RF exchanger. So we need the in and the out, which we found out they're basically floppable. They're convertible. You put one on the crafting grid and you can switch it to the other one. So we should be able to do the pieces. No, you're going to be that way. Just fine. That go. Oh, that's right. These aren't stackable. And then those go there. These go here. That gives us one of these. Put another energy unit in there. Give me one of these. And I think we can put, yep. Done. Which gives us two more. And quest completion. I did turn my volume up a little bit, so hopefully it's workable. They do stack. Now, let's see. Okay. Tired. What is the easiest way to test these? I don't think we really have a way at this moment. Let's actually convert you back so you stack and put you in there. Ooh, we gotta do this real quick too. We're gonna have one oddball left. Yep. Okay, next. So that takes care of that one, which opens. Oh no, wait, that was this one. Okay, that one. This thing. The metal former. Requires shears, which I thought was kind of weird when I first saw it. Why do you hate me so much? Metal former. Do I not have all the pieces? I thought I had them all. Are these? I thought they were calculations. I'm betting that thing. Oh, those stack. Oh, shears don't stack. Okay, now this is, if I understand it correctly, this is the cool point of this mod. So here's our metal former. So we should search for networks. Node 1, which is that node right over there. Okay. Apparently that's all it took. And it's pulling power from this node. This node now has, we got 4 of 5 devices. That's what I was looking for right there, load. So we got 3 solar panels, and we got 1 metal former. And it just works, which is really cool. Can we see recipes? Oh dear, that's gonna get confusing. Button. Okay, so it's a little metal former with a squishy icon. We'll get us those. Okay, were there other recipes for this stuff? Iron, okay. That's what I was looking for. We'll just use 7 and 1. And then if we put it in here, we want it on etching, refining, plate crushing. It makes a decent amount of noise. Okay, so it's pulling power. Wow. That's got some range on that noise. Alright, so you're pulling in, you're holding steady. Oh, okay, we can't actually. Oh, there's no UI to this thing. Okay. Seems like it's holding up. That is a remarkably annoying noise. Let's come over here. Okay. Huh? Aren't there supposed to be buttons? I'm confused. Well, that's. Oh, okay. Okay, good. Did we already turn that one in? Yeah, we did. No. Man, I'm losing it. All right, well, whatever. All right, now, this thing. I imagine a better you. The data terminal. This is the one that I've been kind of. I was really tempted to play with this off camera, but I was good and I waited. Because you're just kind of there all the time, aren't you? Data terminal, there you are. Okay, that's this thing. Now I think let's take them up. Make sure. Okay, we'll allow you to manage your network better, as well as what is to come. Once crafted, yep. Right click to install, and then can be toggled by pressing the left Alt key. Okay, so right click. Okay. Oh, it kind of wibbles when you move your mouse over. Boop, boop, boop. Settings. Okay. Don't need those. Don't need that. Oh, no. Go away. Left alt. Okay, there we go. Okay. Yes. And we get this one. Now we go right click. Eh? Don't you have to right click? Oh, no. No. Book. How do we install it? Right click to install the display and then toggle by pressing. Yeep. Oh, this is. Oh, duh. Media player. That's music. Okay. Does it tell us? Okay, it does. Okay. Ooh, you are really annoying. Let's go sleep real quick so it's get brighter up. All right, let's see here. Okay, so we need to look at the app bits next. So, in case I forget, the black stuff over there, it's actually not black. It's actually kind of sparkly. Let's see if this works. I can't get a bucket, darn. It's actually, it's what happens if you melt the essence. Can we have one? Apparently we're gonna get two. Well, it's that stuff right there. It's IMAG phase liquid, so it's this stuff. It's actually really sparkly. If you see it like inside of there, in the pipes, everywhere it's sparkly, except inside those tanks, which is really weird. Let's stand over here for a minute. Okay, let's see. We got you done. Phase refinement. I have no idea what you are. More equipment you're going to need to refine some crystal. Find those crystals. That's where they make. Oh, okay, the fuser. Supply liquid phase and mela buckets. Okay. Input. How do we make you? Well, aren't you marginally complicated? Okay, two calculations, a squarey thing, then we squarey thing. Okay. Let's see if we have the materials for that real quick. So we need four of you, one of you, to get one of these little cubey things. Alright, cubey thing. And where are you? There you are. That one. Two calculations. Okay, so this data, calculation. Two calculation chips. One of these. I think we needed a couple of these, didn't we? It always moves it. Where'd it go? Blind. Can't see it. It's right in front of me. I know it's here. There it is. Yeah, four of those calculations. One of you, which is glass around four constraints. Okay, so two, four. All right, piece of glass. Got a piece of glass. Set that. Okay, gets us four of these. Here and here, that goes there. If I remember right, these go here and here, this goes here, and you go there. All right, that gets us the fuser. And ooh, enough out of you. Neat machine, but needs to be somewhere else. Let's see, which means this one's probably going to be annoying too. Let's take a peek here. Let's put it right there. Wait, fizzle sticks. Let's put both of them right here. It's totally intentional. Wireless networks. Connect to that one. Link failed. Why? Oh, you're too far away. What's your range? Your range must be really crappy. Let's put it. Okay. Here. Here. Yay! Ooh, no. Ooh. Do liquid flux. Okay. Let's put you here. Will you connect? Link successful. Okay, good. Okay, now we need liquidy stuff. I think that's what these units are for. Can we fill these out of here? Can make it into buckets. We can. You can kind of see it, a little swirly going on there. So I think we can just put this stuff in there. Okay, so they got liquid in it now. You ate them? That's rude. That doesn't give us the canisters back. Okay. Okay, let's see. That goes there. Holy smokes, look at all this stuff. I have no idea what time I pushed the record button. Let's see if we go over today or not. Put you in there, you in there. You 3000 power, It's like, yeah, IMAG flux or something, like the IF, I think is the abbreviation. So let's put you. Well, that's an interesting sound too. Here, let's just do that. A little more. There we go. Headset has a volume control on it. Little sliders, quite useful at times. Okay. So that got us that one. App Store. This is one of the ones, App Installer. How do we make you? Ooh, what are you? Data ship we got. Data ship plus glowstone. Do we? Haha, we do. Alright. Data chips. Data ship. No, like that. That's right. That one's picky. Alright, that one. Some of these are, when they say shape crafting, man, do they mean it? A resonator. Okay, so one resonant, redstone, two. No. Resonant. Nope. One of these. Two of these. The constraint metal plates seem to be quite popular in these recipes. But then again, this mod only has what? I mean, not even a full page of components. So I suppose it makes sense. That one. That's that piece. What are you? The resonator. Wait, didn't we just make the resonator? Do I have all three? No. Data chip. The most simple, basic component. And I was completely missing it. There and there. Okay, that gives us the app installer. Does that mean we can install that one? Successfully installed the app frequency transmitter. Yay! Next. Okay, it happens. Okay, good. That's the music player. Okay. Which means now we can install that one. And we can install that one. And then if we hit left control, we bring up the thingamajiggy. All right, we got the frequency transmitter, which will allow us to pair and link the various. Oh, that's interesting. The mouse physically cannot move off this area. The devices, the solar panels, the machines, all that stuff. Apparently we can do linking with this thing. Like we can manually click this. Okay, I want this node to control this, that type of thing. Media player. Wow, they even took the pictures right off the anime. Surprising, got in trouble for that. Okay, let's see. That will play music that I do not want to get nicked for a copyright violation on, so we're not going to do that. All right, we got that one. That's completed. That's not done yet because we have not made this thing. How bad are you? What in the world is that? Oh, a portable developer. If we already had that, we can make the bed. We don't have the portable developer, which means now we gotta make all these little bits. Pistons are easy enough. Ooh, okay, let me make some fiddly bits and I'll be back real quick. Okay, and we're back. Let's close out of you. Media player actually does work. I'm gonna have to look and see if I can put MP3s or something into that folder and see if maybe it'll let me play them. All right, it took me maybe 5-10 minutes to make all these pieces, because for the most part a lot of them are simple, they're just fairly fiddly, so it takes you a little bit. Luckily the machine had created one of these before it ran out of liquid, so apparently 3-4 of those little jars are enough to make one. So this gives us our normal ability developer. Probably should have checked the recording time. Oh well. Here. So far one of the things I've noticed with this mod, other than the fact that now it is dark out and it's hard to see, the items and the blocks have really high detail on them, which isn't something you normally see in Minecraft. I mean, to me, the icons that you hold in your hand look a little kind of weird, but I think that's what happens when you try to make something detailed and something that isn't. But it kind of strikes me as like, you know, you look at this thing, it looks neat. So does the solar panel. I mean, to me, this just looks neat. It also strikes me as something that if I had a bunch of them, probably is not healthy for my game client. So let's go here. We did that one. Okay, so you crafted it, and apparently that's all we had to do to complete it. Which now lets us do the progress tracker, which is a compass, a data chip, and another one of those pesky little buggers. So we need two data chips. Nuts. I completely already lost it. Ah, okay, got it. Wish me. No, this one. Glowstone, that's what we need. That one. Okay, so got that compass. Okay, I haven't made one of these in ages. That's why I did cheat and look. Compass. Okay. Gives us the compass, the data chip, and that gives us that. We can install it, but we do not have anything for it yet, so we will open this up. Wireless bars, there you are. Connect, of course. Can I break you without you exploding? Okay, good. Let's put you right here. Wireless bars, connect. Why? Oh. Yep. Pop. Something tells me we are not going to have enough power. Which, let's see, that's the bridge out. Let's do a bridge in. Will this work? All right, I want you to connect. Ooh, every time. I keep forgetting that thing has limited range. I wish it would tell us how far it could go. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Is that far enough? Okay, good. Ooh, look at it go. Okay. Got energy now. Okay, so if we come in here, link is successful. Okay. Nope, I don't want to be out. Okay, so we push that button. You are about to perform upgrade to level 1. It requires 3500 IF. Start. Okay. Yeah. Oh, it's a Windows progress bar. Kind of goes, and then it goes back, and then it goes a little more. It's like those old times when you used to download off of a modem. Fluctuating current. Okay, action successful. Looks like it gave us the Electromaster one, which is interesting because that's actually the main power of the character, or the power of the main character in the show. So we want to learn this ability. So what I did was I clicked on it to bring it up here. UI overlay is a little weird. It doesn't quite box fit everything. So we're going to hit learn. It's going to take 2100 IF. We're going to let that go. And, okay, this one goes a little faster. Successful. All right. Which gives us then current charging. No idea what that is. Let's escape. Get out of the thingy. Get our left control. Okay. Skill tree. Okay, so we can get to this anywhere, but how? Nope. Oh, okay. Escape options, controls. Okay. COFH empower quell item. Let's just get rid of you. Where's that village mod? Mechanism. Does anybody else have V? Railcraft. Streaming, which I've never used because my ID is still old school. I have not converted it. Which I should probably do someday. Why did I go right by it? I don't see any more. Oh, wait, there it is, right there. No, that's Mariculture. Keep going. Okay, I guess. One of the versions of Ogo used to have a conflicts button where you can go into controls and there's a button you can click and it would show you all the key bindings that were conflicting with each other. Because see, no known village closer than 2 kilometers. Keep searching. Can't bring that up. How do you? It's got to be in here somewhere. It's not there. Video settings. It's got to be in controls. There's got to be a button in here somewhere I'm missing. Actually, can we go back here? Let's hit our control key. Let's go into settings. See, activate ability, edit presets. So it'd be V. And switch preset is C. Open data terminal. Left. I think that's L menu. Don't know what button that is. That's got to be the Alt button. Debugging console. Okay. And V is what I need, but it's being overridden by that Millennial Village mod. Wait, I remember seeing that somewhere. There it is. M. UI settings, maybe? There you are. How do we change you? Will that work? Is that all I have to do? Okay. So that brings it up. And I got a little buzzer on my screen here. No idea how to actually use it. Alright, book. Portable developer, okay. Firstly, you can circumvent it by installing. Wait. Getting sick of having to go back to the ability developer to check your skill level. Okay, so we can make the portable brain not working, ability developer. But how do you actually use the abilities? Because that's kind of an important thing. Okay, so yeah, here's the types. Electromaster, Meltdown, or Teleporter. Each have unique abilities. Leveling up, which is basically use them to use them. Ah, there we go. N. Okay. Knew it would be in there somewhere. So N, preset, arc generation. Okay, close that. Now, if I hit V, that brings it up. I can shoot lightning. Okay, there's a recoil. It looks like that little bar goes down. I can shoot it again. It goes back up. Either that or that's the you will kill yourself if you use this too much thing. Do I have something I can zap with this? Ooh, let's make a chicken. Make a chicken real quick here. So it sounds like the more you use... Ooh, hello. Okay, we gotta try it. Electricity underwater. Hey, come here. Doesn't work on you, why not? Oh, we got cows. Let's go abuse some cows. In a nice, humane manner, of course. Well, as humane as you can get with electricity. Let's see. Cows. Ooh, yeah. Wow. 3.5 hearts? No, 4.5. That's interesting. Now, see, the bar up top is changing colors, which kind of has me wondering what that means. Because it doesn't seem to me like it would be a good thing. But let's go V, turn that off, so that I'm not accidentally frying things I don't mean to. And let's go back and jump in the little pod here and see what it says. So, actually, let's eat some non-nutritious bread real quick. Into the tube. What does tube say? Ooh, a little bit of gray right there. Wow. 2.7%. Like, cooking there. Not acquired. What are you? Arc generation. Don't know what you do. Can't learn you because I have not learned enough. I don't know if it means I literally need to learn it until it hits that line where it connects it, or if I have to fully utilize it, which means I will need to level these up by zapping things. The progress tracker, that was the data terminal, which more fiddly bits. And maybe we'll make that one next time. What I want to try here, do I have any of them in here? I do not. In here? Yes, there's one. Okay, and you're an out bit. So if I come over here, way over here. I'm going to need another node, I think. So if I was to put... If I was to come over here, break you, put you right there. Okay? And then put you right there. Okay? You're connected, but there are no wireless networks in range because, you know, it's way over here and that thing has horrible range. So if we come back over here, let's find out how fiddly this is going to be. Advanced. No, we need. No, that's improved. Stop that. Stop it. Basic. Oh, not bad. Two iron. Okay. Let's see. Can I? How long can I hold on to that? So I need two iron. Two, three, four, and crap, gone. Oh well. Almost. I know I need a data chip. Oh, it's a calculation. Well, I had that wrong. Okay. So two of these, one of these, calculation chip. That do I have everything? I think I got everything. That goes there. Goes here. Nope, not a sword. You go there. Alright, let's see. So this thing should have like 50 blocks worth of range. So configure. Search for networks. Not connected, can't see any. Okay, how about here? Can you see them here? You cannot see them here. How about here? I thought that thing said 50 blocks. Ah, range. Oh, 24. Wow, okay, so apparently that 50 does not mean what you think it means. Okay, so it means 24. data. Okay, that's not that bad. Let's try that. Why am I holding a shovel? Okay, 2 redstone, 3 redstone, okay. 2 data, 4 of those. 3 redstone, 2 of those, that's what I was missing. 2 of these. Okay, so another blocky thing. Okay, and then we need the extra redstone. Come back into here. You there and there, you there and there. Nope, there. The block isn't actually there yet. There, that gives us another one of these things. We also need 3 more of these, and then we're going to need, how hard are you to make? Oh, you're an upgrade to the previous one, which is an upgrade. All right, data, crystal, 3 thingies. So data, one of these, 3, you know what, let's grab 10 of these, 60 of these, 10 of these, that's not 10, that's 9, data, low purity, 3 of those. Ooh, do I really want that many of those? Probably not, since they don't stack. Let's just grab a few of them. And, nope, wrong, nope. You sort. Let's go plop this down really quick so it's not taking up space. Okay, 24 blocks. Don't know if it's spherical or circle. Wait, what are these? So let's just go 5, 10, 15, 20. So in theory, that's like 22 right there. So if we come over, say here maybe, and then we put these in there. See, it doesn't have a thingy yet. So let's, I think I read this right and it said that you could daisy chain these things. So let's find out. How crazy am I? Okay. So got that. Need a calculation, one of those little crystal thingies. So calculation, crystal thingy, energy unit. Okay. And data calculation. Okay, so pretty much one of everything. So one of these, one of these, one of those, one of these. Yeah, I think that's it. Yep, and that gives us this thing, which is the basic horrible one. Sounds like, well, you know what? Do we have... We have one of these, and we have one of these. Was it like that? That gives us the improved one. So if we come over here and we take you out, and it goes flop. And then we take the improved, and we put the improved in there. Capacity 1 of 20. Nope, now you're down to, okay. Yeah. Bandwidth, okay, let's just get, no, come on. No, that's not escape, that's why. Okay, so the range is now 33.94. That's remarkably specific. Okay, so now if we come over to you and we give it that, can I do this? Action failed. So how do we daisy chain them, I wonder? So test 2. Action successful. Okay, so if we come over here, oof, 24, that might be pushing it. Let me put you here. Can we see? We cannot. It's got to be a sphere, maybe. Can we see it here? Yep. Okay, it was right there. So how about here? No. Here. No. Okay, apparently right there is the magic spot. Okay, so you're connected up to there. You're not even No! Uh-oh. Okay, so after a crash, which I guess comes from random button flailing, I'm guessing, my G keys on my keyboard are set to my left and right mouse button. I think that's what I was hitting instead of escape, and I think it made it mad. Right now I'm trying to figure this range thing out. So I took down the other one. So we've got the one with the advanced or the improved. And so right here, okay, let's try this again, E-O, escape, there. Okay, so it says range 33.9 meters, SSID is test, 33 meters. I set this thing right here on this line, each one of those blocks is 5. 33 is way over here where the torches are. Something isn't right, because nothing. But let's find out. I know if I put it right there, it works. What if I put it right here? Nope. Okay. Here. Yes. Okay. So, see? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Not 33. No idea what I'm doing wrong here. Let's try it right here. Nope. So, okay. 7 blocks. 7 blocks, not far. Not far for 7 blocks. 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay? Not much. But now the real question, though, I suppose, would be, can these things be daisy-chained? I know there's a way, I thought, or at least I thought there was, that you could string these things together. But something's not working. So if we do, let's just put this right here. And because unnamed. Okay, yeah, that's right. We need to name the node. So we name the node. Rename. No. It's just node 1. Ta-da! Nope. Okay, come over here. Right click. Node 1. Link is successful. Good. Node 1. Yep. Node 1. Yep. How about you? Can you see node 1? You can. Good. Ooh, fizzle sticks. Okay. Let's put you here. No. In case anybody's curious, by now I think we're at like 40 minutes. Put this here. Link successful. That's good because it's only 3 blocks away from you. 2, 2.5-ish. Okay, so has load. Has no energy. Why do you not have energy? Link successful. Yay. Yep. Why do you have 0? That will not fill up. Had energy before. Okay, so if we put you here, we open you up, can you do anything? You can search for networks, but we don't see anything. So I think this may require some fiddling, because I don't know how these things work. It really does seem like it should be kind of obvious. You know, the better thing you put in it, the better it works. But It says it's supposed to have a 39 block range, but something is definitely not right. We don't have a password set into it, so that's not going to be a problem. It can support 240 IF per tick, which is really good. So I don't know how this is going to work. I was really hoping I could transmit some power over there, but I guess not. I'm getting flowers everywhere. So, don't know. May have to play with this some more. I get that? Okay, good. So, I think for the time being, we'll just... Let's see, I think when I placed it down... Yeah, oops, no. It seems like if I put it right here, it goes into these blocks. So, this being the lower right-hand corner facing you, that seems to be how it goes. Let's do one more thing before we wrap up here. That thing being, let's upgrade this to the next tier. Bounce. Oh, lag as this area loads because I haven't been over in the door over here since I had logged in. Two of these. Then we need, do we blind? Apparently. Guess so. Maybe. I thought I had a bunch of these. Good enough. Let's come over here, and while we're running, the current project is the Ardite Bees, but until I venture back into the Nether again, which hopefully will not kill me, I only have one block of Ardite, so it's slowing things down a little bit. We need like that, and good enough. Wait, that goes there for now. I broke the power over there, so technically I suppose I should keep that on me so I can fix it. Let's put you away, keep you and you. To upgrade you, we needed one of these and one of these. That takes our basic, I think, was it that way? Yeah, converts it into one of those. This right here, think was the conversion pattern. Yep. Okay, that gives us the advanced, which should give us more, which will give us more range that doesn't work. So wait, it does not go in you. It goes in you. That. Okay. Now we need the constraint metal plates that I put away. Three. So we get its little floaty bits on it. And range is now 41.57 meters. Definitely reading that wrong. So SSID, we'll just call it main for now. No idea what's up with this thing. Okay, and then if I give you a network, I don't... Uh-oh. Crud. Okay. I have no idea what's up. I mean, I have not had these things crash. I mean, we made them last episode and none of these issues happened, and now all of a sudden this thing is functioning properly. So I don't know, because this is saying 41 meters. Maybe it just has some funky load to it. I don't know, but it's like I say, I don't know. It's crashing the server a lot, which really concerns me because I keep forgetting to make backups of the save file, which, you know, not exactly a good thing. Being a person who works in IT, I should know better, but I just haven't done it yet. So we'll see how long until that bites me in the butt. So I think what we may do is not touch that again this time. Plus, we're pretty much out of time as it stands right now anyways, so we're going to check on the bugs here, see how they're doing. Okay, we're back up to 7 or so. I can't remember. I think we had like 3 or 4. How are these doing? These are at 27. They have spewed out some false positives, which is fine. I think I have... I don't remember how that thing is set. Oh, there's a filter. That's right. There's one of those... one of these. So, any bees go up here, anything else goes that way. That's what it was. That's how it's filtering out. So yep, we've got some of those in there, so we're doing okay. Those are fine. Need to look at these and see how the enchanteds are doing. Let's put the cobalt back in here before I start coughing and go fix the thing I broke over here so that the centrifuge works, because I did run a, in case you're wondering where this came from, I ran a power line from basically the basement level here, the first basement level, and it follows this and goes all the way to, I think it's like right here. No, right here, because it, that pipe comes up in the center. And then it also goes directly under this one, and it comes up right here and gives this one power. Eventually, the idea would be to run another line over there so I can kind of start webbing this area with power lines so that we can power these things. I don't know if the alveary stabilizer requires power. All I know is it didn't seem to work at all for the cobalts until I had it plugged in, but that could be because normally what I was doing was it would, I'd get a cobalt queen and I'd put the queen in here and it wouldn't work. So finally what I started doing was actually putting the princess and the drone and letting them combine in here. And that's when it started working. So more than likely it's just a coincidence and the power probably isn't needed, but I don't know. That thing's got power again, which is good. This thing is connected, not, wait, you can see it, but you can't connect to it? Why not? Weird. Let's just whatever. It's already looking horrible. Whoa, no, too far. Oh, don't crash on me again. Things are not going well. I have no idea what's going on. This is not what I'm going to qualify as a good thing. There we go. Give me that back. Something is seriously lagging here. We need an in. Okay, that goes there. Can you connect node one? Fine. Why not? It's right there. Weird. Why can you see it, but you can't connect to it? Huh. Do we need more? I don't hope it doesn't need to be any closer, but maybe it does. How about, let's see, what are we? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Wow, I missed that entirely, didn't I? There, just take a bunch of them. Here and here. No, and here. Yay! No, you're the out, not the in. Why do you look so similar? Okay, yeah, yep, okay, good. Plenty of power now, good. That way the thingy, normal ability developer will work. Okay, I think with two crashes and a whole bunch of I don't understand why this is not working the way it seems like it should be working, I think we're going to call it here. We're going to say thank you for watching. If you liked the episode, please hit that like button. If you're not subscribed and you want to see more videos, hit that subscribe button and you will see more videos. If you happen to know someone who might like watching the ability developer get set up and us picking a power that we can turn on like this and zap things with, which is really actually kind of cool, send them a link. And, you know, maybe they'll like the video. Maybe they'll subscribe. And then, you know, you get to be happy that you made somebody else happy. And I get to be happy for channel support, which is awesome and always appreciated. So, again, thank you for watching.